We're shaking, folks. Back with another reaction, back with some more Rage Against the Machine. Really feeling this band again. It's been many years since I've listened to them, and, you know, I've mentioned it in the first video that I reacted to from them, Township Rebellion, or the first song I reacted to. Again, if you're new here, I react to physical media on this channel. I've been collecting music for, you know, going on like 37, 38 years. I'm 41. I started buying like cassette tapes when I was like 4 or 5, something like that, so... yeah, I've been collecting a lot of music over the years, especially, you know, vinyl records and CDs, so that's what I do here. So if you're expecting a YouTube video, I do apologize. I know that's what a lot of people do, nothing against that, but yeah, I just celebrate physical media and the, you know, the artwork and so on, although it's a bit ironic to say that because I don't actually have the original case or the booklet for this album, but this is actually the original disc. A lot of, you know, some of my punk rock records or CDs, you know, I played the hell out of them and they were in and out of CD cases and maybe got really scratched or, you know, I've lost some over the years, and in recent times I've replaced some of them. But yeah, I don't have the artwork for this, and this is actually the original CD that I had, you know, now for about 30 years, so, yeah, we're gonna listen to a tune, Freedom. This was a request from Ryan, shout out to Ryan. It's funny, I remember most of this album. I do remember this song to a certain degree. I remember there's a real kind of like, again, molten lava sort of yell that he does of the name of the track. But as I sit here, I am struggling to think of the sonics a little bit, and you know, one can get a sense of the sort of, you know, hybrid style, the heavy, it's like hard, like metal, but it's also got sort of a groove and a funk to it. But this particular, the musical arrangement of this particular song eludes me as I think about it. So, yeah, and lyrically too, I don't remember this one as much as, you know, like Know Your Enemy or Township Rebellion, which I already reacted to, or Killing in the Name Of, which, you know, it was a close second, to Township Rebellion. I really love Killing in the Name Of. I'll get to that one. Although it just says Killing in the Name here, so maybe it's just Killing in the Name. I always thought of it as Killing in the Name Of, but as I see the track list written very clearly on the disc here, it's just Killing in the Name. So, regardless, yeah, let's get to it. This is Freedom by Rage Against the Machine, the final track on their self-titled debut album, 1992, though as I did mention before, I believe they had recorded, written and recorded these tunes at least a year earlier on a self-release cassette tape, but then they eventually were picked up by Epic Records. So here we go. Freedom. Oh, fuck. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. All right. My bad, folks. I'm back on. It's such a good sound. Oh, that little, like, that high, like, metallic kind of guitar, like... This song is fantastic. Make sure we're not redlining. It's like coming back to me as we get to it. I love the sort of pot and pan percussion.
Anger is a gift.
No! It can be, is what I'll say to that. It can be a burden too, though. And a danger. But I get it, it's like... It's the embodiment of the album, of the ethos, of the... sort of philosophy of the man. You can't be idle, you can't be complacent. You have to fight for your freedom. And then Morello is just like, let me do my thing. It's like bluesy, yeah?
at that bass.
Again, as it's happening. Wasn't one of the songs on this? Maybe this one? In the very end of the first Matrix movie? Like when he hangs up the phone and flies into the air? Am I right, Ben?
On the level of our unconsciousness. For example, what does the billboard say? Come and play, come and play. Forget about the movement.
Yeah, get lost in the sort of mindless, depraved, consumeristic driven public culture. Forget about your ideals and your activism. Go to sleep.
Anger is a gift.
Remember that, like, I don't know how you sing like that without destroying your throat, but I commend him for doing it. Again, it's hard, but it's got a funk and a groove to it, like. Back to like shocking one of my friends because I had gotten this album and started listening to it. And a friend of mine that I had known since like second grade, since we were like seven or something, he came over and I played this and he was like, what the hell is this? How did you sing like that without dying? Somebody tell me. It's like the end of Dead Kennedy's Plastic Surgery Disasters record. And then this voiceover comes like, please take your standardized drugs. You're like, your local authority will be by to collect your urine sample. I do apologize, folks. If you made it through that, if your ears still exist, yeah, I do apologize. I forgot it was that, like, intense. I mean, I know in a way that's the point. It's like, you know, that feedback, that unpleasant nature is, in a way, sort of designed to embody the idea that you have to be made uncomfortable. You have to get out of your comfort zone. You have to wake up, realize what's happening, you know, make connections with other demographic groups, recognize, you know, commonalities and try to forge something new and better. But yeah, ultimately, I didn't realize it would be quite that loud. So if you had headphones on, I do apologize. I'll put a note in the description that like, hey, right at the end of the song, beware, it is a bit intense. But yeah, that's a brilliant tune. I remembered sort of the song as it was unfolding, certainly. But yeah, that's a really good one. I do believe back in the day I liked that one a lot. Again, it sort of sparked a memory of playing that tune specifically for a friend of mine, and we started shouting with those just, again, you know, plasma hot vocals near the end. My friend was a bit like, I think, intimidated, a bit scared. But yeah, it's a brilliant tune. I'll admit the lyrics on that one, you know, I don't have as full a sense of the sort of contours of some of the lines there. So let me know if, you know, there's a couple lines or a theme or a concept that you think is particularly interesting or worthy of discussing. Other than that, thank you for listening and watching. I will see you next time. Peace.